Recording? Right. Good afternoon. Oh, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Tommy's trying to play with the old Corey there. Now, I've got my three cousins here.
Two.
Your two cousins, sorry.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tommy. Now.
I'm very switched on, sir.
Yeah. Now, this man has been very elusive in his interview. He's still not sure about this today, but we sort of cornered him into it.
Persuaded him a bit,
mate. Bullied me into it, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Wait till you get outside a minute.
Right. this is Thomas Charles Matthews, right?
Thomas Charles, to be honest with you.
That's what you said.
Yeah, Thomas Charles, come on. This is the oldest son of Janet and Tommy Matthews.
Right. And this is Pat. Well, you all know Pat from before.
Third brother down.
Right. Now, Tommy, we're not going to do your in-depth interview this morning.
Gotta go back where I started now. Come here. Come on.
We'll just do a few funny clips. You've had a series.
After that, I'll do that.
Right, fair enough. So here we go.
I was born down Charlie Hawkins Yard.
Right.
In a tent.
You were?
Then my father lost his license for 10 years.
10 years?
So they decided, yes, true, Clarence.
Right.
Then they decided to travel with Uncle Joey and Caroline and Nation.
Right.
Down to Nancy Collins, apart.
Carleen.
Right.
And then we got back, after we finished travelling, they decided, now they built a chalet up atop of the field where our grannies live. And we all live there. But then my mother and father split up.
Right.
Chalet was sold, as you know.
Right.
And then the four brothers broke up.
Right.
Two went and lived with granny.
Right.
And the other two youngest ones, Patrick and Joseph, went and lived with Uncle Brian and Harry. Am I right?
Joseph went with Clarence, I stayed with Daddy for a while.
Well, old man went up with Eileen.
Oh, with her.
Now they went up a country for 18 months. Yeah. And then they bought a place at Trevarth.
Right.
Of Uncle Edwin.
Right.
Then we was made to get out of there because of the council.
Right.
Then our days, really, we called on. Nothing like it was Lanneril.
You called that Channel View this morning?
Channel View. That was our own, wasn't it, Pat?
Yeah.
We had some fun up there. Oh, we were always breaking horses.
Right.
Joseph Pat and the dogs. Me and Freddie was giving our man arm with horses.
Right.
But that's where it all began up there.
We had a lot of donkeys too, didn't you?
Oh, my God.
Donkey dogs.
I think it was me and Freddie. No, Pat, it was there in the back of the horse box.
Going up
over Bray Hill.
Bray Hill.
Lee Stanley and Dunsey was trying to give one another one.
No.
Now, we had to separate them. So the H, is the truth there, the H had come off.
We screaming.
Of the Land Rover, down the other side, bloody great drop.
Terror.
Yeah.
It's come off.
Yeah.
He had
so
a safety chain on.
We done camera and table, Sean. We done camera and table.
Right.
Now, these donkeys, they had tools on them like that.
Right.
Well, the other donkey was running like that. He was trying to get it up, his ring piece. Well, his ring piece were no bigger than that.
Yeah. Oh my God. Oh,
they were the days, remember?
Right. So the box come off.
Box come off, remember, on the chain.
To that Campbell Ring table and Alf Garnett.
He was driving boiling water.
Boiling water.
Alf Garnett,
yeah, on the same day that was.
Yeah. 3 degrees was there.
We got
what
a clip from a West Britain clip.
With 3 degrees?
Yeah, 3 degrees.
Benny was there from Crossroads.
Right.
Yeah, my life, yeah. Oh, we had some fun up there. We was at Charles, was up to car bonnets. Mother and father used to go to Plymouth every year.
4,000 bonnets, that's
with green green shield slice. Stamps. Yeah, my life.
Yeah.
Some fun.
So you had like chariots with the bonnets?
Car bonnets, it was.
Yeah.
Standing up. Benner. Yeah. We had some fun. Best days of our life.
Right, before we forget now, you told me about old man with a spanner. What's that story? Yes.
Oh, he was a...
What happened?
Bear in mind, our father was a very strict man.
I love him to bits.
Right.
As a person.
Right.
But as a father, he was a bastard.
Right.
He said, will you go in and find a 916 spanner? Well, at this particular time, I didn't know what a 916 was.
Right.
I didn't even know how to count up to 10.
Right.
He was always a little bit slow, like, you know?
Right.
So he sent me in his tool shed to pick up 916s. I was in there scrabbling for a toolbox. Have you found out yet, boy? I said, have you found that yet? There it is. And he would beat the spanner into my head like that. Well, if it had ink on it, I'd have had a permanent bloody tattoo clearance. Right. You know what I mean?
I understand.
Yeah. That's it now.
Oh, that is
starters.
That is it, yeah.
Give you a little taste for a minute.
Just tell us a couple more funny stories, man.
I don't know any.
Oh, Tommy, come
you
on.
You told us plenty a minute ago. What was the other one there, Clark? He said.
Well, when he got tied up.
No, I can't mention that one. Cause friction. Now, me and Uncle Samson have tied Patrick up to a forklift. Raised the forklift up, tied that squirt of gas from a gas bottle.
Electrical wire.
That you cut. Like that, Patrick here.
Help, I said an help. Over Eddie Dunson's
room. Yeah, scrapyard.
That wasn't funny though.
Well, we found it funny.
Well, we didn't.
Well, we cannot, man. It's gone too long now.
Well,
yeah. What was in their heads to do that?
I don't know.
Then Eddie, with that spring, a bit his eye.
Sure.
Cheap car. A car spring.
Right.
Bit his eye.
Right.
Yeah.
Remember when we went to Danny Cooper's drive and Danny Calloway stepped at the box? Mr. Stephanie.
All the way up, I was checking the saucepan. We had Savoy cabbage, tatey, and a big gammon like that. And I kept taking the lid on and off. That night we tried to go to sleep. Danny Galloway have stepped out of the lorry, with stepped out eye. And Shane now, 2 o'clock in the morning, kept taking the lid on and off. Clarence said, he got stopped. Stop, I said, Shane, do that one more time, I'm going to put you to sleep. Yeah. Too much drink on.
We're ambitious. Let's get that thing straight here. We used to be a bloke live outside we, called Zamba.
Zamba.
The turban on his head.
Right.
When Tommy was learning the drive, he had angle on it up. Oh, beautiful car, right, carry on.
I said, Sambo, my friend, will you...
Get the car stick.
Will you sit beside me, please? Yes, Mr. Dam. He sat beside me. Freddie was in the back. Where Blythe is this now? That big hump? Oh, I struck him. Is he had a car like
half J's on her.
All his turban have come off. He said, drop me off. I said, no, you're fucking staying here, man. Yeah.
That's the one we used
he
to
went on the old man.
Yeah.
He said, Mr. Tom, never again. No. I'll sit side E. He fighting in the death club.
We used to go down our disco. Me and he used
to. I learned how to drive.
Yeah.
Learned he and my brother Freddie how to drive. On my life.
He fought me the keys down.
Penzance, Newland.
See you. Take the keys. Drive us home. Me, you and Susan, right? We're fishing.
Good old days.
We used to come back and push Andy down the lane because
oh man, suffer with with migraines. Yeah, he'd give a shit. He would. Right, that's it now. Stop him. Let's have a look back. They're gonna have some laugh at this. I got nearly 8,000 views.
Leave him
on that. No, on that thing I cooked with a frying pan. On Chloe's leg. On Chloe's leg. Have a look.
After you.
I like it, see.
Up there.